was given to her through her intestine for 5 solid years. And then she went back to London, and then the doctor said, we don't have anything to do. You have to die so that they can cover their mistake. But we have a God. Amen. This afternoon, I said, the God of Pentecost, we have a God.
Amen.
Semina, please come. And she came. She stayed with us in Duisburg for 1 solid year. And every man of God who comes to our place lift up their hands and start praying. We prayed, we prayed, we prayed. She never see any specialist. And within less than no time, the healing power of our God. The healing power of our God miraculously healed her. She's gone back to work. She's gone back to London. She's living a normal life. There's no drips on her. And if you have ever seen what I'm saying a few years ago, you would never even have imagined her standing here to sing to the glory of God. We have a God. And I pray that every challenge that you are going through, my father, can I preach it?
Yes.
My father,
yes,
will bring a miracle in your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Right before I preach, let me give you some explanation before we go to the Word of God. Right from the beginning of the year, our theme for the year is we as a church, COP, as a church, hearing and obeying the voice of the Lord in our generation. And here, I stood here the first time we did apostolization, I preached that anytime the Lord mentions somebody's name twice, it means that the Lord wants to elevate that person. He mentioned Jacob's name twice and said, Jacob, Jacob, do not fear to go down to Egypt, but I will be with you. I will go down with you and bring you up. And from there, Jacob's name changed. Jacob's status changed. He mentioned the name of Abraham 2 times when Abraham was about to sacrifice Isaac. He said, Abraham, Abraham, do not lay your hand on the child. Now that I know that you fear me. And then God went into his own self and swore by myself, blessing will I bless you. When God met Moses in the wilderness, Moses had lost direction. He was a murderer, doing a pra-pra in the wilderness, taking care of the father-in-lawship. And God met him by the fire. And God had to call his name twice. Moses, Moses, remove your sandals, for where you are standing is the holy ground. And Moses was elevated to become the deliverer of Israel. Anytime God mentioned your name twice, it means that it is an elevation.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
And Moses rose up as nobody to become a somebody. Amen.
Amen.
So God mentioned somebody's name twice. According to Psalm 62, the Bible says, once the Lord has spoken, twice we have heard, that power belongs to him. So if God will call somebody's name twice, it is elevation. He called the name of Samuel twice. He said, Samuel, Samuel. He said, Master, speak, your servant hears. And from that time, Samuel became the first prophet. He carried the unction. He carried the anointing. He became a judge. He mentioned the name of Peter twice. He said, Peter, Peter, Satan desired to have you, but I prayed. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
And Peter became the first apostle to preach the word, to bring 3,000 souls to the Lord. He mentioned the name of Saul, who became Paul twice. Saul, Saul, why have you risen up against me? Why are you persecuting me? And Saul became the apostle to the Gentiles. He, I mean, half of the New Testament, he wrote it. So anytime God mentions somebody's name twice, it means the person will be elevated.
Amen.
Here comes our thing. Jesus mentioned God's name twice whilst he was in agony. He was in a place of torment. And he hung on the tree. And he said, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? And whilst he mentioned the name, my God, God elevated him. And anytime you mention your father's name twice, can I preach it?
Yes.
You are elevated to a double portion.
Amen.
You are elevated to receive a double portion.
Amen.
To, come on. Receive it now.
Amen. I receive it.
Receive
Amen.
It now.
Amen.
Receive it now.
Amen.
You are elevated to receive the best right. So Jesus said, and my father, my God, why art thou forsaking me? And God said, anyone who believes in me, he will never be in haste. And he shall never be disgraced. So God lifted Jesus Christ. And he became the firstborn among many brethren. He became the first fruit of the dead. Can I preach it?
Yes.
He became, his name became the name above every name. At the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. And every tongue shall confess. And here comes the thing. My father, a disciple mentioning the name of his father twice. And that place is to receive a double portion. To receive something that is double, first fruit, to receive best right, to receive double portion. And pray, P-I-W-C, in Belgium, may you receive a double portion.
Yes.
The best right.
Yes.
In this my father, impartation. May you receive it in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
If somebody has put you down, as you mention the name twice, may God elevate you.
Amen.
May God give you a priestly anointing.
Amen.
A kingly anointing.
Amen.
A prophetic anointing.
Amen.
An unction to function.
Amen.
In a double portion.
Amen.
In an extraordinary way.
Amen.
Somebody say, I receive. My father. Can we shout it again?
My father.
Can we shout it again?
My father.
Can we shout it again?
My father.
Now get ready to receive an impartation. Get ready to receive an impartation in the name of Jesus. Shall we be seated in heavenly places? We are reading from 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 15 to 21. 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 15 to 21. That's our first scripture. I read from the New King James Version. 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 15 to 21. And I read. Then the Lord said to him, go, return.